Hi there, Sagittarius. This is Tanya Lee of Harmonia, and welcome to your general reading for November 2022. If you are new to this channel and you feel guided, go ahead and hit subscribe. Make sure you hit that bell twice. This way you guys get notifications of when I go live. I typically go live for my all zodiac sign reads on weekly on Sundays, okay? I actually haven't been live in quite some time, but I've been uploading them as I've been trying to catch up on personal readings here, Saggies. But also, if you like those all zodiac sign reads, you might want to check out my website at Harmonia Friends, that website right there. It is a paid membership area, guys, a small fee. There's two tiers. There's one where you can just get the TLC all zodiac sign reads Monday through Friday. The second tier has a little bit more. You have the ability to get massive discounts with sign up. Get into my giveaways that I have monthly, including group up calls. We never know what those topics are going to be. Typically, it's a support call. It's great for a support community. But also you get the access to my access point experiences and vlog area. So if that's something that interests you, go check it out. It's unlimited access. You get access to it all, okay? It's not each per reading or anything like that. All right, let's see what's going on for Saggies, okay? Reminder, time is fluid. It's always moving, Saggies. So pay attention more to the storyline, to the characters that come in place for timing purposes, all right? Just take what resonates, leave the rest. Do not force anything to fit. Just because I'm posting this in November doesn't mean it's all happening in November, right? I've had people who go back a year from now and say, this reading resonated to me. Guys, it's not me. It's your intuition of when you feel guided to listen to this, okay? It may be for you. Don't forget to check your other areas within your natal placement chart too for additional messages for the other readings. Here we go. Let's get started. We're going to get started here with the Oracle card, see what your challenge is this month, and then we'll get with the Tarot reading. Calling in our guides, our ancestors, and our ascendant masters as to what messages, spirit, do we have for Sagittarius? What do they need to know in this month's energy? What is going on for our Saggies? Oh, I can feel this energy. Surrender to rest and sleep. Don't we all need that? This kind of reminds me of the Four of Swords. To prevent burnout, slow down. Honor your need for quiet time and peaceful sleep to rejuvenate your mind, body, and spirit, Saggies. Huh, I feel restless. I feel like I don't have the ability to do this. I mean, this could be a challenge for you, is not having that space, not having that time to be able to relax a little bit, feeling a little bit, could be a challenge here to creating space for yourself here, all right? Could have a lot of obstacles come in this this month for you. Well, obstacle is death. This is an ending. This is massive change here, Sagittarius. This month, it is about transformation here. This ending is going to bring a new beginning. Some of you are going to need a lot of, I don't know. I mean, this death can be a lot of different things. There is something ending in your life, and the struggle here may be needing to have a timeout here. I almost feel like an adrenaline rush. it's like you've been working so hard to try to keep something that needs to end, and it's finally over. Something is finally going to be over, and it is going to transform you. So let's see what this is. Restless. It's the challenge here is the ending. It's finally going to be over right here for you. Well, Saggies, there's a lot of people here, and I feel this energy here of you trying to remain grounded, all right? A lot of Taurus energy here, but we also got a lot of air energy, Libra, Gemini. You could be dealing with a Taurus, Libra, Gemini, but it doesn't necessarily mean that. It could be your energy too here. Saggies, I feel like you have had enough with how you've been treated and voicing something that is going to not be the best. Now, you may be dealing with someone like this too, okay? Who's had enough with you, okay? But someone here is angry. Someone here is cutting with their words. Someone here is demanding the truth, wanting the honesty of a situation here, is trying to remain practical, is trying to remain balanced, trying to be secure. This is a hard worker. This is a hard worker. But I feel this energy. Of someone either missing someone or missing an opportunity. Saggies, okay? Because it's wanting to move forward towards this Empress energy, which is loving, which is security, which is bossing up, which is ultimate receiving, a rebirth. But something has to end to get this rebirth. And someone may feel they missed an opportunity with an individual. Now, this may be someone on your end. But this is usually looking in the mirror, focusing on there, like, what have I done? What? And I feel a lot of reflection here. Reflecting on what it is to be in a strong partnership of equal give and take. This doesn't have to be love. It is, though, something where someone was focused on missing out on the opportunity and someone is now realizing their worth. But here's the thing. You got that Two of Swords underneath that Empress. So an ending hasn't happened. Someone here may be worried that, you know, if Saggies, this is you in a toxic situation here, wishing, you know, knowing your worth or seeing someone of other value here who could level you up, boss you up, or even a promotion here, Saggies, you're in a situation where it's kind of not nice. It feels unequal. And really feeling like you're missing out on other opportunities where there could be growth, but also fear of it falling backwards. Is it going to end up the same? I could be talking to a Saggy here who's non-committal or has issues of things from the past that have come up that stop an individual from moving forward in anything because of all of the failures they've had. This ending is happening regardless. You are leaving a relationship, a situationship, a friendship, or something here that you know is not going to push you forward. Many of you are restless. Many of you need that rest to prevent burnout, slow down, honor your need for quiet time and peaceful. You can't get this with this person or this environment or this situationship. This could be a boss, an arrogant boss here who keeps you from having new beginnings, right? Wishing you had new opportunities, wanting to know your worth. But there is an ending and it is not stagnant here. Now this card, the Sad Squirrel, is particular for this deck, the medley deck. But with it reversed, I feel that you're having clarity now that this isn't going to change. If you want it to change, you have to be the change. The stagnancy here is having that clarification. It's like, if I want to make myself happy, if I want to see the growth, I got to be in charge of that. This is a wake-up call. I feel like you got a wake-up call here, or you're dealing with an individual here who needs a rude awakening. Let's see what the validation cards. Remember, I don't do reversals and validations. Evaluation here. Rude awakening here. You've already seen what this person, their truth, their honesty. This is a lot of spying going on here, Saggies. All right. Now the Page of Swords is wanting the truth. Nothing but the truth. At all costs, we'll get the truth. It's the same thing over and over again. The Eight of Swords is to keep you stuck, but the Nine of Swords to me is, and that's what I keep seeing, is the Nine of Swords really is the nightmare stage. Someone here has massive anxiety of not making a right choice, you know, and having someone here keep tapping on them, keeping them stuck. But it's all in your head. The only person keeping you stuck, Saggies, is you. You can get out of that. A choice. I told you, someone here feels like they made a poor choice. Now, this could go vice versa here, but that's a choice of a partnership, a new partnership, or having the ability here to take on a new partnership, a rebirth here, okay? Some of you, if this is love, you have two options here. One who's more of a rebirth here, one who's boss level, one who knows their worth. One who I feel you may be giving to an individual here who does not know their worth, who is very arrogant, who is very cold-hearted. But if it's not love, guys, this could be work something here where you have an opportunity here, okay? And it doesn't have to be new love or current love. This could be an old situation that has been haunting you, you know? The Lovers is a choice. Five of Wands on that Queen of Swords. It's nothing but fights. It's nothing about arguments. You're not going anywhere. The constant bickering, the constant need to move forward. It's like you can't get your ground in the situation with this person. This person is very fighting with their words. This person wants to give you anxiety. This person gives you a lot of gaslighting, very arrogant. It's their truth, but it doesn't necessarily mean it's your truth. I'm hearing, Saggies. Okay. There's something about this individual who passively aggressively gives you their problems as though you are the problem. Four of Wands. All right. This is definitely a partnership here. This is definitely someone you collaborate here. This is definitely something environment. Some of you, this is your home environment. Some of you are married to this individual. Some of you are committed to a work environment here that gives you a lot of anxiety. Some of you are afraid of commitment because of a past situation that did not go so well. And very indecisive about going towards new love. But it has to be you, Saggy, who offers it. There's something about you offering it, taking the opportunity. Oh my God, Ten of Pentacles. This is what you're going towards if you end this agony, if you become the change. The decision is yours, Sagittarius. This is security. This is safety. This is family. This is coming together. This is a home. This is building. You have the ability to build a very solid relationship or move on to a job that is feeling very solid to you. I feel very restless in this situation here, not creating time. And there's something about this individual doing that so that you don't have time to think. They want you to feel that way. It's eggshells, right? It's never going to be an equal give and take with this individual. They may even breadcrumb you, okay? They may make you empty promises. They may start taking care of themselves and then flipping around again, all right? So, Saggies, this is someone here who has no, and I love that, you know, it's funny because we got the Queen of Swords here and the sad squirrel here reverse. This individual is miserable regardless of the situation. This person gives all of their power away basically to you by blaming you. And you allow it by working with them, by collaborating with them. Doesn't necessarily mean you're taking it on, but you allow it and it keeps you stagnant. it keeps you stuck. And you know the only way you're going to untie yourself is to get yourself out of that. Are you kidding me? You got the Hermit here, which is all about going within. Virgo energy. This is deep in thought. This is knowing your wishes, your dreams. You got to be the change, but it's time, all right? Like, regardless, this is going to end regardless. But it's got to be you who makes a change, or you will feel stuck. You will never have the ability to be at peace. You will never have the ability, because you're being pushed to do something on your own, to really sit back, listen to your heart. There is an opportunity for you to do something differently. And you're going to need that space to feel confident in it, to feel at rest with it. And some of you, it's to make peace with this situation of this individual who never will get out of this. It's reversed. This is an individual who will always be the doom and gloom. They're just the way they are. Let's see what the final message is for Sagittarius. When I cultivate a spiritual connection, I can trust the universe no matter what. When I cultivate a spiritual connection, you got to work with the universe. The universe has been offering you a chance to end this, but there's something here where you know that you got to be the change in this. This individual will not change. They will try and try and try, but they won't be able to keep the persistence of change. It does not mean that you have to hate them or block them. It's called love, peace, know your worth, because you do have someone here who values you, who will work with you, who will be very balanced with you, with that Empress energy here, all right? But the crossroads for you is to trust the intuition that if you let this go, this will be here for you. Some of you already have this, and you've just been really afraid to take the leap towards this, all right? All right, guys, that's what I have. If this resonated, go ahead and hit like, comment below. Don't forget to share. Would love to see you at Harmonia Friends. But don't forget, I also have a free Facebook group. It's called Harmonia Friends as well. Become a member there. Sometimes I post my exclusive content. So check it out. Take care, guys.